The e-commerce scene is here. It's real and it's in full swing. For real. If you don't know what e-commerce is, basically whatever products or services you're selling, you digitalize them and put them online for your customers to buy there. That's your e-commerce store. And what better way to open your e-commerce store than Shopify, an all-in-one online store builder, fully equipped for you to start your e-commerce journey. If you're lost now, don't worry. In this Shopify tutorial for beginners, I'll guide you through all the steps needed to get you started on Shopify as quickly as how your products are sold out. I'm Robert from Pagefly, and before we dig in, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more content like this. First up, you need a Shopify account. Access Shopify.com or click the link in the description below and click Start Free Trial. In the next couple of pages, Shopify will ask you a bunch of quick questions about your business background in order to tailor your store building experience. So if you want a smoother journey with Shopify, feel free to answer all of these questions. If not, you can skip one, two, or all of them and have them configured later. Well, I need an example to show you guys anyways, so I'm gonna power through all of this as if I'm a fashion store owner. Once done, create your Shopify ID using one of these methods. All set! You've got your Shopify account. This is your Shopify admin dashboard. Now, let's be kids for a while. Do you know what kids do? They curiously play around their newly bought toys until they figure out how they work. So, essentially in this step, I want you to take a tour around your dashboard first and get familiar with your master control room in near future. Here on the left sidebar, we've got a bunch of configurations. But for beginners who are in their store building phase, you need to know these first. Home, product, content, and discounts. Below that are your sales channels, online store and POS, or point of sale. Next up, a section dedicated to Shopify integrable apps. We'll get to that later. And a small settings button that reveals a bunch more settings. Don't be afraid, I've got you momentarily. What's a store without products? Let's add our first product. On your dashboard and on the left sidebar, select products. If you're new here, click add your product. There are loads of information to take in here, but here are the basics you should keep in mind. Your product's name, I'll say luxury white dress. Your product's description, make it enticing. Become the next miss with this luxury white dress. Media to help people visualize your product. Your product's price, comparative price, and actual cost per item. Amount in stock and its weight for shipping. Variants like sizes and colors. Product category, type, and tag. Click save and your product is up for sale. Okay, pro tip. I'm a fashion store owner and I have lots of varied clothing collections. If you're like me who's selling products of different categories, use Shopify's collection feature. On your dashboard, on the left sidebar, select products, then collections. click on Create Collection. Fill in your collection's name, description, and how you want to add your products into collection. There are two ways, manually and automatically. If you choose the latter, you need to set conditions for it. Normally, I'll use tags for it. Add your collection image if desired and click Save. Congrats! Your smorgasbord of products just got organized and your customer will now have an easier time looking at your offering. Alright, themes. The visual foundation. You've heard of it, you've had it on your phone and your computer. Now you have it for your online store too. On the dashboard, click on Online Store and choose Themes. Here you can see your defaultly chosen theme, Dawn. For the record, it's a nice starter theme, but you can choose from 12 free themes or almost 150 paid themes starting from only $150 down here in this section. Once you've selected your theme, customize it by utilizing all the settings in this Shopify theme editor. Save it and your theme should now be visible live. You'll always want a store that looks like what and how you intend to sell. So another pro tip, use theme filters on Shopify theme store. Access themes.shopify.com/themes and look at the left side of the screen. You'll see a bunch of options that filter out themes that match your exact needs. Whether you look for free or paid themes, which services they are suitable for, or how many products they can cater, Shopify makes sure that you can find your e-commerce BFF in no time. Easy to set up, but crucial. Configure your store's name and domain. Shopify automatically set up a domain for your store, but it looks like this. Customers won't have a good time finding your online store, that's for sure. Here, click on Settings. On Store Details, click Edit. Now, change it into your store's name. Navigate slightly below, you'll see Domains. Click on Change to a new myshopify.com domain. Then configure your desired domain. Ideally, you should set it as your exact store's name for easy recognition. Click Save and you're donezo. While we're here, let's configure a few more essential settings. Payments. Set up how your customers can make a purchase. COD, deposit, PayPal, Visa, etc. The more the better. Checkout. Configure what information they must provide at checkout. Do not worry too much as Shopify has filled in basic information requirements. Shipping and delivery. Choose where you can ship your products to and how much you charge for each type of shipping. Normally there are two types, domestic and international. Locations, set up where your store is. Taxes and duties, manage how taxes are applied based on the location you've set earlier. And policy, the boring required stuff. There are return, shipping, privacy policy, TOS and contact info. At this point, you basically have everything set up. Let your store go on a test drive. Type in your store's URL on your browser's address bar, or simply click on this eye icon next to online stores here. You'll be directed straight to your live store. Go ahead and take a look at every page and try out any function. Or if you don't know what to test out or see if you've had enough to get going, try out Shopify's general checklist in the description below. Your store is done. Great. But now the general public can't access your store yet because it's password protected. You can set up your password here, by going to online store, then preferences, then password protection. Set it up and bring it to your customers so they can get on your online store. But wait, no one does that, obviously. You need a Shopify plan in order to remove this and actually launch your store. Click on this box on the bottom right to get an overview of Shopify's pricing plans, from small retail to multi-continental enterprise level, starting from $1 a month for your first 3 months to try out all Shopify goodies. Access shopify.com/pricing to know more. And once you pick your plans, your store is password free and available for all viewing. Congratulations! You've launched your online store. Your e-commerce business is up and running. Fantastic. But at some point, your needs might exceed beyond Shopify's offerings. That's where Shopify Integrable Apps come in. Access apps.shopify.com for a full display. These are third-party apps created by independent developers who join forces with Shopify to elevate your store building experience to that infinity and beyond. There are apps that add pop-ups on your store, send emails for abandoned purchases, or build stunning pages for you. Once you've got your sights on one potential helper, click on install. It'll direct you to installation page, and once done, a newly integrated app should appear on your Shopify dashboard, ready to use. And I've heard this one works like a charm. You've got your online store, but you don't want to ditch your brick and mortar store as well. Cases like this call for Shopify POS, a Shopify-powered hardware that you can easily install on your physical store. Even if this means replacing your current POS system, Shopify POS ensures that your offline and online store stay in sync. For example, you just sold 3 items in your physical store. This will be updated on the internal system that tells how many items left are in stock across your every sale channel. In addition, Shopify POS provides smooth checkout, staff management, and more. That was just as easy as 1, 2, 3. Keep in mind, this tutorial is only a quick guide to get you started on Shopify as soon as possible. Hopefully, after this tutorial, you've got a grasp of how Shopify works, how you can operate and improve your e-commerce store, and get juicy sales from it. Thank you for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel to learn more about e-commerce. Until next time.